What's going on, Riverwalk? Woo! What is the reason why we're out here?
Jesus!
Jesus! Everybody give Jesus some praise out here right now. Excited about tonight. It's like there's an unction, there's like fire in my bones, man. The word that the Lord has put on my heart, man, is something that I believe is going to transform us tonight. It's going to empower us to walk in the glory of God. It's going to empower us to touch His children that are lost. Amen?
Amen.
Amen. Who's excited?
Yes.
How many know that every time the word of God is spoken, that something shifts in our hearts? Amen? Something changes. Hallelujah.
Yes.
Who's ready for some change in their heart tonight?
Hallelujah.
Who came expecting something? Who came expecting a move of the Holy Spirit? Amen. So before we get started, I just want to say a prayer over worship. My sister Hannah came out here. She's going to worship for us. Heavenly Father, God, I just ask right now that you would pour out a spirit of wisdom and revelation, God, even as we worship, Father, that you would give us revelation of who we're worshiping, of who you are, that you're a good Father, and that you deserve to be worshiped. You need to be worshiped, Father. Father, we owe you everything. We are nothing without you. God, I ask that as we worship, that we would keep our eyes on you, Jesus.
Yeah.
That we would not be focused on things around us, but we would look to the heavens at our Savior who died upon the cross and resurrected to empower us by the resurrection and the power of the Holy Spirit. God, I ask God, that you be with us in worship. Holy Spirit, you are welcome in this place.
Yes.
Holy Spirit, come. Even in worship, I ask that the power of worship would begin to break off strongholds, God. God, we speak life over every individual, over every heart. God, let us worship you as if you were here. Because you are here with us, God.
Yes.
Your presence is here, God. And we thank you for your presence,
Jesus,
God. In Jesus' name. Amen.
Yes.
And let's worship God. And He gives you every breath that you breathe. Every breath that you breathe is given by the Creator of the heavens and the earth. Amen.
Amen.
Let's worship Him as
Hallelujah.
He is.
Hallelujah.
Your love is so cold, like the
Where I find Hallelujah.
Oh, man. Who can acknowledge that song? Say, praise is our God. Amen. Praise is our God.
Hallelujah.
It's your breath in our lungs. So we pour out our praise. Amen. Man, it's God's breath in our lungs.
Yeah.
Every breath is given by the living God.
Hallelujah.
Father, we praise you for that, Lord.
Thank you, Lord.
Praise the name of Jesus, Father. Oh, everybody, give Jesus some praise. Amen.
Yeah.
Amen. Everybody, give Hannah beautiful voice. Thank you for coming and worshiping her.
Yeah.
Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. Man, so excited. Who's ready to receive some tonight?
Woo!
Who can expect to receive from the Lord? Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen, man. We should be able to worship all night. We should be able to work. We should never get tired of worshiping. We should never say, oh, that's enough songs now. No, we need to worship God. We need to be in our presence worshiping God. Amen. We need to be on our knees worshiping God. Thanking him for who he is in our life, for snatching us out of sin and making us slaves to righteousness. Amen.
Amen. Come on.
Amen. Hallelujah. Man, so excited about tonight, man. As I said, oh man, I haven't, you know, for those of you who don't know too much about Riverwalk, so what Riverwalk is a place where we come together in unity, truth, and love for the streets. Amen. Amen. Where churches come together, where unbelievers come and find Jesus Christ. Amen?
Amen.
Man, the reason why we're out here is because God has called and chosen us to be disciples of Jesus. Amen? And he wants us to walk in that. Man, how many know that the darkness creeping up on this world is coming fast, it's coming quick? And how many know that we are the light of the world? Amen? Man, we're going to talk a little bit about that tonight. Man, we're going to talk about a lifestyle of Christianity as a lifestyle of evangelism. A lifestyle of power evangelism, of presence-driven evangelism. Amen?
Amen.
Amen. Oh, I'm excited. Man, how many of you enjoy sharing the love of Christ everywhere you go?
Hallelujah.
Amen. We are called to do that. Man, can you guys join? Let's join in prayer. Before the word comes forth.
Oh, Father.
Father in heaven, we thank you for who you are. Father, we thank you for who you are. We thank you that you're a good, good Father who loves us. Father, I ask God in the name of Jesus that you would move me to the side. That you would speak through me, Father. That you give me ears to hear and eyes to see. Father, that you would give everybody here ears to see and eyes to see. That you would open up spiritual blinders in the name of Jesus. God, that every word that is spoken, God, would be put on firm soil that would bear much fruit, God. That would bear fruit to others for even to pick from and eat, God. God, I ask in the name of Jesus that you would bless each and every person out here. Father, I ask that your presence would come. When your presence is here, it changes everything. Father, we thank you for your presence. We thank you that where two or three are gathered, you are in the midst, Father. Father, the living God, the God of the universe, waiting for a relationship with us, waiting to talk to us, longing for affection. God, take us to a deeper intimacy with you, Father, a deeper revelation of who you are in our lives. Father, we thank you, God. We come here to glorify your name, to lift up the name of your only begotten Son, who became sin, who knew no sin, and became sin to set us free and give us eternal life in heaven as we follow him. God, we thank you, God, for every heart. I speak to every heart, and I ask that you would soften every heart, that they would be ready to receive what you have for them today, God. God, that you'd even bring forth a spirit of conviction, God, that would help us and empower us. God, we thank you for the Holy Ghost, which empowers us to walk in victory, yeah. which empowers us to walk over sin, God. God, I ask, Father, we ask, Father, in the name above all names, that you would come and that you would reside in our hearts, that you would shift things, that you would reveal things in our hearts that are not right with you, God, and we would lay them down at the foot of the cross. Father, we thank you for your love, for your grace, and for your mercy over our life. God, release your anointing over this place, God. Yeah. God, we ask that your anointing would break yokes today, Father. Father, your word is not just word, it is power, God. And we ask for your power, God.
Hallelujah.
Father, in the name of Jesus, bless every ear to hear, God. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. And who's ready to hear the word of God? I just want to say to Adrian, my brother Adrian came out. He was here last week. He spoke on unforgiveness. Unforgiveness. Man, how many know that unforgiveness is important? If God might even be highlighting somebody to you right now in your heart that you need to forgive about something in your life. And you need to go home tonight and you need to ask God, how do I forgive them? Give me the strength to forgive them. Thank you for that word, Adrian. And I just want to say thank you to all my brothers, man, that come out here faithfully. Daniel, you come out here, man, it's so beautiful. Riverwalk started, we were out here just preaching the gospel. Now God has released brothers out here walking in uncompromised truth, walking in the spirit of God to come out here and preach the gospel. How many know it's not about me, it's not about them, it's about Jesus Christ and his name being lifted up. Amen? Amen. Father, we thank you, Lord. So like I said, we're going to talk about a lifestyle of evangelism. Life. Yeah, I think Adrian has Lord, we ask for the microphone.
We receive it. Okay.
Hallelujah.
Lifestyle of power evangelism.
Turn this down somewhere.
Okay, so the definition of evangelism. The definition of evangelism is spreading the gospel by public preaching and personal witness. Amen? Public preaching and personal witness.
I got it, bro.
So, public, how many of you know that
all of you are called to be ministers of the gospel of Jesus Christ? Amen? Every single one of you. Just because you're not up here or you don't have a place to go, man, you're all called to be ministers of the gospel. We are all called to do the work of an evangelist. Amen? Man. And this city needs it. Man, I'm believing for breakthrough in the city. I'm believing Sarasota and Bradenton. I'm believing that this will be a place of refuge when the darkness comes. This will be a city of refuge that people will come and flock. And the presence of God will come and rest in this place. Will rest in Sarasota. Amen?
Amen.
How many of you believe in that with me?
Come on.
Public preaching. Doesn't just mean right here. It means at the gas stations, the grocery stores. It means at Walmart, at CVS, anywhere you go. You're called to be a minister. And ministering doesn't always mean just speaking gospel and speaking verses over people. No, it's the love of Christ. You share the love of Christ. And we're going to get into this stuff right now. And a personal witness. There's people that don't read their Bibles, but they read us Christians. Amen? Man, if they're reading us as Christians, how are we living according to God's word? Are we living according to God's word? Man, let me tell you, there's nothing worse than seeing a Christian who just has a sour face and everything just completely upset all day long, and people see them or they're in their workplace every day and they just look miserable. That is not a good witness of Jesus Christ, because Jesus Christ brings you the true joy, the true peace, and the true love. Amen?
Right, that's right.
And we need to check our joy and our peace level.
That's
if
right.
Our joy and peace level ain't up, we need to go get in the closet.
Come on.
We need to go seek the Lord's face. Amen?
Come on.
Amen.
That's good.
Personal witness. We can't just be out here preaching and saying things from the word and we're not even living it.
That's good.
Amen. We got to live it.
Come on.
We got to be uncompromised voices of truth.
Come on.
Amen. How many of you are uncompromised voices of truth?
Let's
Amen.
Go.
Man, God is raising up an army of burning ones, burning with passion, burning with desire, burning for the knowledge of who God is. He's raising them up. And each and every one of you are called and chosen. The living God called and chose you in this hour, in this time that we're in, to be light to the world. Does that not excite you?
Come on.
Amen. Personal witness. The best gospel preached is the one that's lived. Now I'm going to go to Philemon 1, 4 through 7. Now let me tell you, this is from personal experience as well. Man, when you share the love of Christ, when you minister in the streets, wherever you are, you begin to learn more about what you have in Jesus Christ. You begin to, it's necessary for even your own growth in Christ. For your own growth in Christ, it's necessary to go share the love of Christ and talk about who our Father is. Philemon 1, 4 through 7, it says, I always thank my God as I remember you in my prayers, because I hear about your faith in the Lord Jesus and your love for all the saints. I pray that you may be active in sharing your faith so that you will have full understanding of every good thing we have in Christ. We need to be active in sharing our faith so we can have full understanding of every good thing that we have in Christ. There's people out here who don't even know every good thing we have in Christ. Man, people out here don't know their identity. Sons and daughters of a living God. I talk about it all the time. We need to get a hold of what that means. We walk in authority. We walk in sonship. Man, we have authority to cure diseases. We have authority to cast out devils. Amen?
Come on.
Amen. Matthew 5:14-10. You are the light of the world. A city that is set on a hill cannot be hidden. We are the light of the world. What are we doing about it? Man, how many know the parable about the lampstand? How many of you have your lampstand up under the table for no one to see? Or how many of you are declaring, you know, I'm up here, I'm not even preaching to you. I'm just up here standing on the rooftops. Standing on the rooftops, exclaiming the truth of the gospel. Amen? Yeah. We need to just be standing on the rooftops, being that light in this dark world. Man, when we go somewhere, the atmosphere shifts. Amen. Something changes. Amen? Man, the presence of the living God is in us. The hope of glory is hoping to get out and touch somebody. And what are we doing? Are we allowing him to get out and touch somebody? Are we bringing somebody Jesus Christ? Thank you, Father.
That's good.
Next part. Why it's so important. It is the Great Commission. The Great Commission is Mark 16:15-18. And he said to them, go into all the world and preach the gospel to every creature. He who believes and is baptized will be saved. And he who does not believe will be condemned. And these signs will follow all who believe. In my name, they will cast out demons. They will speak with new tongues. They will take up serpents. They will lay hands on the sick and they shall recover. He said, they will. He didn't say this pastor, this preacher, this teacher, this apostle. He said, to all who believe. Every one of you are called to walk in this. Man, when you see somebody sick on the side, pray for them in faith that they're going to be healed. I've been seeing some crazy stuff lately, and I think that's why God has birthed this word in me, that we need to get stirred up. I believe God is going to release healing wells, and the healing wells are within you. I believe that God is going to move on your behalf when you step out in faith, step out in boldness. He's going to move in this hour. Man, I've been, just to share a brief testimony, I was at CVS. I was at CVS when I didn't know why I was there. I all the glory to God. The Holy Spirit said, go to the CVS. Didn't know what I was doing there. But you know, when you're obedient, things happen. Amen. How many know obedience is important? When you hear that still small voice, when you hear that the Spirit of the living God tell you to do something, do it. Even if it sounds crazy, do it, because God has a reason for it. Amen?
Amen.
Man, I went to the CVS. I sat on the hood of my car, and I was praying in the Spirit, just singing in the Spirit, blessing people as they went by. A guy walks by, his ankle is broken, a broken ankle. There's four people behind him. Lord says, pray for him. I go over, I pray for him, quick. God, in Jesus' name, I command healing. All pain come out. He said he felt a tingling. It was healed, a broken ankle. In Jesus' name, Jesus healed his ankle. And that opened up the door. There were four people behind him that saw him limping. And when they saw me done praying and he was moving his ankle like that, they were like, what just happened? And I was like, Jesus happened. Amen. He's alive today. He's breathing. He's living and active. And he can live inside
Hallelujah.
Of you. He wants to live inside of you. Amen?
Amen.
And in that same moment, there's a woman in the back of the CVS parking lot. And I just hear somebody just start crying more than I've ever heard. Like things just got broke off. And there was another prophetic lady. I didn't even know her. She was at the CVS and she spoke a word over somebody at CVS. And the lady completely just broke. God used this lady in the CVS. Man, we were having church in the CVS parking lot. Amen. How many know that we are the church? Amen. It doesn't have to be behind those four walls. We need to get outside of those four walls. Especially in this darkness, in this hour that we're in. We need to share the love of Christ. We need to step out and be believers, man. Have genuine faith. Have genuine faith in what God's word says and walk in it. Everybody, people say they have faith, but in the Bible it says genuine faith, true faith, unfeigned faith. If there's genuine faith, true faith, and unfeigned faith, there is a feigned faith. There is an ungenuine faith. Man, we need to believe God's word with our heart. Believing in our mind is not enough. We need to believe in our heart what God's word says.
Yeah, come on.
And if we don't, we need to say, God, I believe, help my unbelief. Amen. Amen.
That's good.
Amen. Oh, thank you, Father. Great commission. This is God's heart, to go into the world and preach all the gospel. God's heart. Here's the other great commission in Matthew 28:18-20. And Jesus came to them and spoke to them, saying, all authority has been given to me in the heaven and the earth. Go therefore and make disciples of all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, teaching them to observe all things I have commanded you, and lo, I am with you always, even to the end of the age. Yeah. Hallelujah!
Come on.
He is with us even to the end of the age. Anywhere we are, he's right there. We need to get a revelation that God, the living God, is walking with me. I have authority to cast out the enemy. I have authority. I am a son of the living God. When Satan comes to you and tries to speak things over you that exalt itself over the imaginations that exalt itself over the word of God, you just say, no, stop. I am a son of the living God. I cast that down and keep it moving. Amen.
Yeah.
You have authority over your mind. You have authority over your flesh by the power of the Holy Spirit. We're going to get into this stuff. Authority as sons and daughters of the living God. In Romans 8:15, this is so important in this hour. We need to know our identity. We need to know who we are in Christ, and we need to walk in it. And everything is birthed out of prayer. Everything, man, I cannot say prayer enough. We need to be intimate with the Father. He's longing for intimacy. Man, the living God is waiting for you in your bedroom.
Amen.
He's waiting for you. Amen?
Yeah, that's right.
Man, Romans 8:15-17. For you did not receive the spirit of bondage to fear, but you received the spirit of adoption. Hallelujah.
Yeah, come on.
The spirit of adoption. We are no longer orphans. We are no longer orphans. We are sons and daughters of the living God. By whom we cry out, Abba, Father. Abba, Father, as the Spirit himself bears witness with our spirit that we are children of God. And if children, then we are heirs. Heirs of God and co-heirs of Christ. If indeed we suffer with him, we also may be glorified with him. Man, we are heirs of God. I can't even wrap my head around that. When I can read these things every day, and I'm still in awe. Like, I am a son of the living God. You are a daughter. I am an heir of God. I am a co-heir of Christ.
Hallelujah.
Are we really grasping what
Come
that
on.
Is? Listen to what heirs say, what the definition of heirs is. A person legally entitled to the property or rank of another. We are legally entitled to the property or rank of the living God. Hallelujah. Glory.
Come on.
Another definition. A person inheriting and continuing a legacy of a predecessor.
Hallelujah.
Continuing. Inheritance. Man, we've inherited. Man. God has so much for us. He has so much for us. There's nothing in this world that'll ever come an eighth of an inch close to what God has for us and what God wants to do in our life. And we have to sacrifice. God says we must pick up our cross and follow Jesus daily and deny ourselves. Ourself is the problem half the time.
Yeah, amen. That's right.
We need to deny ourselves. We need to say, Jesus, give me the strength. I'm following you today.
Amen.
Come on.
Wake up in the morning. Get on your knees. Cry out, God, thank you for the breath I breathe. Thank you for who I am. Teach me. How many know the Holy Spirit is your teacher? He will lead you into all truth. Amen. Man, we need to get to know the Holy Spirit, the person of the Holy Spirit. We're going to get into that in a second as well. Man, there's another verse. It says that Jesus was the firstborn of many brothers. I don't know if you guys got that. Jesus was the firstborn of many brothers. That means Jesus is my big brother. Jesus Christ is my big brother. He's your big brother. You can walk in what Jesus walked in. Jesus said that you will do greater things than even I.
Yeah.
Man.
Come on.
It's coming. It's coming. We need to get ready. We need to get ready to walk in this, man.
Yeah.
We need to get all that nasty sin out of all that stuff in our life. God loves every one of you. God loves everyone in the world, but he hates the sin. Sin separates yourself from God. Any sin in you, the wages of sin is death, point blank period. Not actual death, no. Not right away, but one compromise at a time brings spiritual death. One compromise, then one more compromise, then one more. You're spiritually dead.
Yeah.
Man, the devil comes to kill, steal, and destroy. We need to beat our bodies and make it our slave, as Apostle Paul says. Amen?
Yeah.
Amen.
Come on.
2 Corinthians 5, 20-21. Here's some more of who we are now. 5:20-21. Now then, we are ambassadors of Christ. Ambassadors of Christ. Man, how many of you are excited that you're an ambassador of Christ?
Hallelujah.
The definition of ambassador: a person who acts as a representative or promoter of a specified person or activity. Man, God called us to be an ambassador of Christ. Man, we were so unworthy. We were so unworthy. We need to wrap ourselves around this, God. God, bring revelation of who we are, Father. Bury it in our spirit, God. Let it stir our spirits up even now, God. God, I ask that those seeds are planted right now in Jesus' name, God. Oh, man. It says that we're the promoter of a specified activity or person. Jesus is the star. Jesus is the star. We need to bring people Jesus Christ. You know, I see some people evangelize, and you know, sometimes it throws me off. You know, we're always talking to them. Sometimes people go up to people, they don't even get to know them. They're like, hey, what's your name? Okay, and then they're like, they say the sinner's prayer, and then they're like, oh, I got another one. There's another one in the kingdom. And they don't even remember the person's name that they just talked to. I'm like, these are people. We're talking to people. Man, like, we need to bring them Jesus Christ. We don't need to walk up to somebody and say, hey, Jesus is way over there. Let me tell you how to get to Jesus. He's over there. No, Jesus is here. Let's bring people Jesus by the love of Christ, by the power and the authority that we have. We don't have to take people way over there. Jesus isn't far in this far distant place. Jesus is in you. Amen? Amen. We represent the Jesus in the kingdom of God. Jesus was there for sinners. Jesus was there for us when we were sinners. We are here for the sinners. Amen? Everybody needs a touch. When you go out, don't go out and say, looking for people. You don't have to necessarily look for people. You don't have to be like, oh, they need Jesus. No, everybody needs Jesus. Everybody. There's not one person who needs a touch from Jesus Christ. Everybody needs Jesus Christ. Even a believer needs a touch from Jesus Christ. Amen? It doesn't matter. We don't need to go out and say, oh, well, maybe him. No, everybody needs Jesus. Point blank period. Amen? Man, if you see people anywhere engaged, and man, honestly, sometimes our lives are hectic. You know, and people make these evangelism groups and say, hey, we're going to meet up Tuesday, and we're going to get together, and we're going to evangelize. All five of us are going to go out and evangelize. That's awesome. I'm not knocking it. But some of us have lives, and we can't do that stuff. So So we need to make this a lifestyle. Everywhere we go, no matter where we are, somebody needs the love of Christ. I don't care if they're having a good day. Give them a better day. Give them some more Jesus if they're having one. Amen?
Good.
Hallelujah.
That's good.
Hallelujah.
Come on.
This is why I said, Jesus is the real star. We're just the hype man. Amen. We're the hype man. Jesus is the star.
Hallelujah.
You gotta get people hyped for Jesus. How many are you excited about Jesus?
Come on.
You gotta get excited. You gotta get ready to launch and grow. God, send me. Here I am. Send me, Lord. Man, when we get in the car and we're headed to the store, God, I thank you for that person you're bringing me to. I thank you. I claim victory over their lives. God, bring me that divine connection, that divine appointment, so I can share your love. We need to start praying. God, send them. I'm ready. Anyone who needs the love, send them to me. Let me walk past them. Let me give them a smile. Amen?
Hallelujah.
Amen. And look, when I'm talking about healing and miracles and things like that, I'm not out here trying to teach you how to heal and do miracles. I'm trying to teach you who you are in Christ.
Amen.
That's it. Because when you know who you are in Christ, you walk in it. You walk in it. Amen?
Yeah.
You don't need to be taught how to do healing and miracles. I hear everybody talking about, oh, I need to learn how to do healing. No, you need to learn your identity.
Yes, come on.
Our birthright as sons and daughters of the Most High God is to manifest the kingdom. That is our birthright. We are to manifest the kingdom of God. No one is safe from a blessing when you know who you are in Christ. No one is safe from a blessing. Anywhere you go, when you know who you are in Christ, nobody's safe. They're going to get blessed by the Lord in you. Amen?
Amen?
And how many of you guys want to be blessings to others?
Yeah.
Amen? How many know that we are blessed to be a blessing? Not for any other reason. We're blessed to be a blessing. Oh, Father, thank you, Lord. Oh, I see God just stirring up spirits right now. Father, I thank you, Lord. Bless them, Father. Give them more. And now we're going to get into the love of God. It says in 1 John 4, it says that God is love. Amen? 1 John 4:11, beloved, if God so loved us, we also ought to love one another. We have got to love one another. Even in the body of Christ, we have got to love one another when we're out in the street. 1 John 4:7. Beloved, let us love one another, for love is of God. And we're talking about love now. Love is the greatest gift. It's the greatest gift that you can give somebody is love. Amen. Amen. Matthew. Oh. And the disciples asked, what's the greatest commandment, Father? What's the greatest commandment I need to follow? And he gave them two. Matthew 22:37. Jesus said, you shall love the Lord your God with all your heart, with all your soul, and with all your mind. How many out here love the Lord God with all their heart, mind, and soul? Amen? We need to love him. With every ounce of our being, we need to be devoted to the living God. Man, I'm talking about a relationship. I ain't talking about religion. I'm talking about, hey, for those of you who aren't married or that are married and you have that significant other and you love them, you would never do nothing to hurt them. You would never do anything that they wouldn't like. That's what a relationship with God looks like. When you fall so deeply in love with the living God, you're like, God, I don't want to do anything that's wrong. I don't do anything that would separate myself from you. That's a relationship with God. Falling in love with God. Having a relationship, talking to God about everything, praying without ceasing, going to God in all things, every situation. God, is this what you want? God, is this the way that you're leading me? Man, give thanks in every circumstance. No matter what things look like, God's will for your life is to give thanks in every circumstance.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Come on.
How many know some of you guys have mountains in front of you right now? And God's moving those mountains right now. Amen.
Come on.
God, there's no mountain bigger than our God.
Amen.
There's no mountain bigger than our God.
Amen.
Man, we need to praise God in the storm.
Yes.
And watch him move.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Then the second greatest commandment. That was the first greatest. Then the second is like it. You shall love your neighbor as yourself. And the Greek translation of neighbor, it means nearby. Anyone you're nearby, love them as yourself. Anywhere you are, anyone that you're nearby, you need to love them as you love yourself. At the gas pump, when you're pumping gas, think about it. You could even think about, hey, what would be nice for somebody to do for me right now? And go over to the next gas pump and say, hey, let me do this for you. Hey, you know, we need to be generous givers. We need to have a heart of giving. Amen? A heart of blessing others. We need to be able to give and not have a mindset of receiving something. Not having a mindset, man, we need to also check our hearts. Always check your hearts. You can do things out of wrong motives. You can have wrong motives in your heart. How many know that God sees every motive that you have?
Amen.
We need to check our hearts.
Yeah.
He sees everything inside of us. We need to use every opportunity to share the love of Christ. It's a lifestyle everywhere we go. We need to find common ground with somebody, relate to them, and talk to them about it, and share the love. We need to show some interest in somebody, not just show that you're coming with a message. You're not just coming to somebody. No, you're coming because you have interest in them. Because, man, we need to get a picture of eternal life. Huh? We need to know that there is eternal life after this. This life we live is but a vapor. And what is other people's eternal life is based off of their decisions. I can't be quiet. I'm not going to be quiet. I'm going to share the love of Christ. I'm not going to be the one who doesn't say anything, knowing in my heart that something may not be right in their life and they need Jesus. I'm not going to be the one. I will not be quiet. We cannot be quiet. What it said, God did not give us a spirit of bondage of fear.
Yeah.
And a lot of you don't step out and pray for people because of fear. A lot of you don't share the love of Christ because of fear. You know what? Who cares what that person thinks? Because no matter if you go pray for somebody and they don't receive it or nothing happens, they don't get healed, you need to still stand up and say, I'm still a son and daughter of the living God. Let's go, God. Who's next? Show me who's next. Amen?
Yeah.
We need to have that, man. Fear is not of the Lord. Fear stops faith. Feelings stop faith. You need to get those things out. But when you begin to get a thought of fear in your mind, you have that authority. Cast it down in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Fear, get from me. I'm a man of faith. Amen. Speak life over yourself. Speak life over others. There's power in your tongue. Speak life over every situation, over any person that you're talking to. Are you speaking life into them? That's gonna upbuild them. That's gonna bring them up. And let me tell you something else about love. Something about love. A lot of people don't like correction, but let me tell you, correction is one of the greatest forms of love.
Right.
Man, we need to. Hey, when somebody corrects us, thank you. You know, don't receive it right away. Go in your prayer closet and say, Father, if this is me, help me. I want to be correct. I want to be right in your eyes. I don't want anything hindering me from all the blessings you have in my life. Amen?
Amen.
Check our
That's
hearts.
A good word.
Thank you, Father. We need to love people into the kingdom, not push them in. A lot of I hear a lot of people say the sinner's prayer because we box them in a corner to say the sinner's prayer. And they're trying to get us out the way. Man, we need to share the love of Christ. It's not a sales pitch. Bring people to salvation through relationship, not religion.
Amen.
Gotta be authentic, honest, and real.
Come on.
Not trying to trick them into salvation. Oh, Father, we thank you, Lord. How many of you getting stirred up right now?
Amen.
Amen. Amen. I love that. Stay stirred up. We gotta stay hungry. We gotta stay stirred up. God was dealing with me about the trip. I know I'm going off the topic, but God's dealing with me about the tribulation. We need to stay hungry, we need to stay in humility, and we need to stay humble.
Amen.
When we're walking, we need to stay tribulation. Man, what's the other one? Oh, then he told me the triple S. Sacrifice. Surrender.
Sold out.
Yes. Thank you, brother. Sacrifice, surrender, and selflessness. Man, we need to walk in this. We need to take the lower seat everywhere we go.
Amen.
God will exalt you in due timing.
Amen.
Amen.
And a lot of, I feel right now that a lot of you have had visions. And God, a lot of you have had visions and you think they're tearing. Let me tell you, in Habakkuk 2 it says, your vision shall not tarry. It shall come to pass. Do not be weary in well-doing. How many had a vision and ready for that thing to bust open?
Amen.
Amen? It's coming. Thank you, Father. Okay, if we return hate, you know, a lot of people, when you go out and try to share the love of Christ, they'll just be hateful to you. You know, return it with love. Don't let it stir you up. Return it with love, because when they see that unconditional love in action, they're going to go home, they're going to lay in their bed at night. They'll be like, dang, God will bring a conviction. Dang, I was really mean to that person. They were just trying to share me love. Man, just share the unconditional love of Christ. Ephesians 5:1. Therefore, be imitators of God as dear children, and walk in love, as Christ also has loved us and given himself for us, an offering and sacrifice to God for a sweet-smelling aroma. It says, therefore, be imitators of God and walk in love. How many got that? That God told us to be imitators of him. How many know that God will never tell you something that he won't empower you to do? If he says it in his word, he's going to empower you to do it. He's going to empower you to walk in it. We can't do it on ourselves, though. We can't do anything without God. We can't do anything without the Spirit of the living God. Man, two more things about we need to be compelled by love. Compelled by love and compelled by compassion. We need to have compassion. We need to walk in compassion. I'm going to read you two verses right here. In Matthew 14:14, when Jesus went ashore, he saw a large crowd and felt compassion for them, and he healed their sick. How many know when you walk in that compassion, when you have that true compassion for somebody, man, the spiritual gifts are going to break out. When you start showing the love and the compassion, man, healing is going to break out. A sign is going to break out. A word of knowledge is going to break out. A word of wisdom is going to break out. Amen. We need to walk in that and compelled by knowing that there's eternal life after this. And I want nobody to go to eternal hell. I don't know about you. I don't want anybody. No one deserves to go there for eternity. Well, actually, we all deserve to go there for eternity. To be honest, we all do. Matthew 20:34, moved with compassion, Jesus touched their eyes, and immediately they regained their sight and followed him. There's another miracle, moved by compassion. There's three or four more verses. We need to ask God, help me to move in the same compassion as Jesus Christ. Amen? Not this false compassion. Not because you're trying to be seen by man, or you want something to happen, or you want a story to tell. No, people ain't a story. They're people. They're people. Luke 24:49, we need to check our heart. We need to have faith directly in the power of God. And Luke 24, this is some of the good stuff right here. You guys ready? We're getting down to the line now. Hold on. Luke 24:49. Behold, I send you the promise of my Father upon you. But tarry in the city of Jerusalem until you are endued with power from on high. Power. Man, God told his disciples to wait before they went out and preached until they were empowered. Until the power from on high came and empowered them to walk in the fullness of Jesus Christ. You know what he's talking about there? He's talking about the baptism of the Holy Spirit and fire. Amen? How do you know what the baptism of the Holy Spirit and fire is? I'm not talking about baptism of water. I'm talking about the baptism of the Holy Spirit and fire. We need to have fire shut up in our bones. Man, just to give you and we're not going after a certain encounter. We're just reaching out to touch God. Man, I'm just going to share a brief testimony of my experience with, man, I was in my bedroom, all the glory to God. I was in my bedroom. I had the Spirit of God came in my bedroom. I had a 5-hour experience in my bedroom, shaking, sweating more profusely, tongues of fire. How many know in the book of Acts it says tongues of fire? How many know tongues is for every believer? Tongues of fire. Tongues empowers us. Tongues is something that we need for spiritual warfare. Man, how many know we need it? Man, I was in my bedroom. Tongues of fire. I couldn't move. Sweating. Speaking languages. I remember looking down at my mouth and being like, what is going on? I was like, what the heck? But after that moment, I knew what it meant to be born again. To be a new creation in Christ. Man, there's some people out here who have not been endued with that power from on high. And God wants to endue you. And God will endue you, but you have to begin to get things out of your life. He'll do it right now tonight. I believe people are going to be baptized in the Spirit tonight. Who's with me? Amen? Matthew 3:11, John the Baptist said, I indeed baptize you with water unto repentance. But he who is coming after me is more powerful, whose sandals I cannot worthy to carry. He will baptize you in the Holy Spirit and fire. Jesus will baptize you in the Holy Spirit and fire. It doesn't matter where you are, when you're giving everything to Jesus Christ and you surrender your life, he will endue you with that power. And that power isn't just to touch people out here, but it's to help you and empower you to walk in the fullness, to empower you to overcome the temptation of sin. How many know that grace is there to help us overcome sin, not to allow us to sin because we have grace? That is not what grace is. Grace empowers us. God's grace is there when we mess up. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. But that doesn't give us the right, hey, I can go do this. I can go do that because God's grace is sufficient. No, that's not biblical. That's not following Jesus Christ. We need to be set apart.
Hallelujah. Amen.
Set apart from this world. Set apart unto God. Amen?
Come on.
How many of you are set apart tonight? Man, y'all get excited. I'm preaching to myself right now. Come on, man. Oh, Father, we thank you. You know what? I'm just going to go into this real quick. God, leave me there. I'm going to go to 1 Corinthians 12. And I'm going to talk about spiritual gifts. I'm not going to go far into it. I'm just going to read it just to get you stirred up. Spiritual gifts. Therefore, are diversities of gifts, but the same Spirit. There are differences of ministries, but the same Lord. And there are diversities of activities, but it's the same God who works all in all. But the manifestation of the Spirit is given to each one for the profit of all. For the profit of all, not for the profit of yourself. God doesn't give you gifts so that you can get glorified. God gives you gifts for the profit of all so that he can be glorified. Amen. In 12:1, and listen to what he says here. This is heavy word. This is heavy verbiage for the living God to say. Said, my brothers, do not be ignorant of spiritual gifts. Do not be ignorant. Man, that's heavy verbiage for the living God to tell us. When God says, do not be ignorant, and then he says, covet and desire earnestly spiritual gifts. The only thing God tells us to covet, the only thing, we need to get stirred up about spirit. If you don't know what the spiritual gifts are, you need to start seeking. Start asking the Lord, show me the spiritual gifts. Show me. Lead me to somebody who is going to help guide me into all truth. That the Holy Spirit will lead you in all truth. But how many know it's good to have some people around you that's walking this thing out? Amen. Okay. Word of knowledge by one Spirit. Word of wisdom to another Spirit. The gift of prophecy to another Spirit. By the faith in the same Spirit. To another, gifts of healing by the same Spirit. To another, the working of miracles. To another prophecy, to another discerning of spirits, to another different kinds of tongues, to another interpretation of tongues. How many know that there are spiritual gifts? And we have a good, good Father, and he wants to give you all, he wants to give you gifts.
Amen.
He wants to empower you. He wants to give you things in order so you can touch the world for the Lord. Amen?
Yeah.
It's not about us, it's about the lost. It's about the broken. It's about the, man, being an evangelism is bringing people to the knowledge of who they are in Christ. Showing them who Jesus Christ is as our Savior. Amen?
Amen.
Oh, thank you. For not. Now I read this in a book. It was an interpretation of tongues by John G. Lake. I just want to share this. Fear not. God is able to perform in you even that which he performed in Jesus and raised you likewise in him. With Christ Jesus and make you reign in dominion over sin instead of being dominated by the powers of evil and darkness. How many know there's powers of evil and darkness? But how many know our God is powerful? He's more powerful than all of us. Get down to the wire now. Romans 15:19. And mighty signs and wonders by the Spirit of God, so that from Jerusalem and round about to Illyricum, I have fully preached the gospel of Christ. He says he has fully preached the gospel of Christ. Signs and wonders. When Jesus ministered the gospel, he ministered the gospel. It was the simplicity of the gospel. When Paul ministered, it was the simplicity of the gospel. How Jesus died for our sins. the sinless, spotless lamb who knew no sin became sin to set us free. And then he was resurrected. A lot of people don't talk about the resurrection. Jesus Christ resurrected on the third day so that we can be resurrected from death to life, so that we can be empowered by the same power, that same resurrection power that raised Jesus Christ from the dead lives inside of you.
Amen.
Wow. The same resurrection power that raised Jesus from the dead. Man, this stuff is living and active.
Come on.
It's at our fingertips. God is yearning to give us good gifts. God is yearning for us to be sons and daughters. 1 Corinthians 4:20. What? Hey, Hannah, can you come up and start standing over this group? 1 Corinthians 4:20. For the kingdom of God is not word, but in power.
Yeah.
Amen.
That's right.
And I'm not just talking about power, signs, and wonders. I'm talking about power in your word.
Yeah.
When somebody speaks words into you, when somebody speaks the gospel in you, something in your heart shifts. The power of the word changes you. It changes you. It's not just signs and wonders, healings and miracles. Yes, when Jesus walked the earth, when he preached the gospel, he healed the sick. Man, how many know that it's God's will to heal all?
Come on.
It is God's will to heal all. And if you pray for somebody and they're not healed, keep it moving. Believe that God's still healing them. And keep on. You will. Man, I heard a guy say one time, he prayed, Todd White, he prayed for 188 people and didn't see one person healed. And he kept it moving. He kept doing it. And then that 189th time, boom, a miracle. And then that 195th time, boom, a miracle. And then that 200th time, boom, miracle. Then that 201st, then that 202nd. Man, now he's got a ministry all over the world. Healing. Man, God honors when you walk in faith. Walk in faith and just know who you are. And know God is with you and he's moving on your behalf. 1 Corinthians 2:4. And by speech and preaching, we're not with enticing words of man's wisdom, but a demonstration of power. Demonstration. Man, imagine this, when you go out in the workplace, I've seen it. Man, sometimes you just walk up to somebody and say, hey, you need healing. There's something wrong with you. God will give you a word. And you just say, you don't even have to say, hey, let me pray for you. You can say, watch this. Watch this. And you can go, and Jesus will heal them. But God didn't say to pray for the sick. He said, command them to be healed in Jesus' name. Man, when we lay our hands on somebody, they can be healed. They don't even need to know Jesus at first. And then that person can be like, what did you do? What just happened? And you can be like, hey, you want to see it again? Go show. If there's somebody else you know that is sick or hurting somewhere, go get them. I'll show you it again. And then you show it to them again. And then they're like, oh my gosh, what's going on? And this time you got 10 people around you. And everyone cannot deny what just happened. And you say, that was Jesus Christ. Jesus Christ did that. He's alive and he loves you. And he said, man, could you imagine if we all walked in this? Man, the whole nation would be on fire. Man, they would know who they are. Man, I've seen people get healed in them. And then you say, hey, God's giving you the same thing. You give your life to Christ, you follow. Let's go pray for somebody. You can take them and show them somebody who needs to be healed. They'll lay hands on that person and they're healed. Now you've empowered somebody else to walk in it. And we need to walk in this. And don't ever get discouraged. Fear and doubt will rule yourself out. Fear and doubt you will rule yourself out. Walk in faith. Faith moves God. Man, last verse for you. Last verse. Matthew 9:37-38. This is something I'm sure millions have been praying for. The harvest truly is plentiful, but the laborers are few. Therefore, pray to the Lord of the harvest to send forth laborers into his harvest. How many of you want to be laborers in the harvest that's coming? Stand up.
Yeah.
Out here who has not fully given their life to Impartation.